the determination, the meaning of Christmas, we would get many definitions, wouldn't we?
Amen.
So instead of looking to mankind for the many, for the meaning of Christmas, we look to the Word.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Reading from Luke chapter 1, verses 78 and 79. We use these words to lay our foundation. Mm-hmm. Amen?
Amen.
Through the tender mercy of our God.
Yes.
Whereby the day spring from on high
mm-hmm.
has visited us
yes.
to give light to this that sit in darkness
yes.
and in the shadow of death to guide our feet
yes.
into the way of peace.
Amen.
Christmas, what does it mean? It's not about a birthday party.
Yes, mm-hmm. yes.
It's not about, because it's a Jesus' birthday.
Yes.
The birth of a little child.
Mm.
Celebrated by the Christian world.
Yes, yes.
The incarnation of God by the way of the virgin birth.
Yes, yes.
And the Word was made flesh.
Yes.
And dwelled among us.
Yes.
And we beheld his glory.
Hey.
The glory as of the only begotten of the Father.
Yes.
The full of grace.
Yes.
And truth with the coming of the day spring
mm.
from on high.
Yes, yes.
Morning broke upon the world's darkness in Bethlehem. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
While men and women
oh, Jesus.
Bruised and bleeding
thank you.
Were in darkness.
Thank you.
They were looking for light.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
The prophet Isaiah said in
Glory.
9:6, it says, unto us
yeah.
a child is born. Unto us a son is given. This prediction is most clear in the application and most glorious in content, most gracious in purpose. It points us to the time when God's Son assumed our nature, entering the world in humiliation, with every detail of the Christmas story. We ask Christmas what it means. Christmas is a manufacture of the celebration of the advent of Christ into the world by a human birth.
Yes, yes.
No one should believe that Christmas makes the beginning of Christ, because the Son who rested on the bosom and fed at the breast of the Virgin Mary for a little while had before the world was rested on the bosom of the Father.
Oh, yeah.
See, God knew he had a son.
Well,
knew that his name shall be called Jesus.
Well,
we've been born in, I was born in Halifax Hospital. We almost were born in hospitals, but Jesus,
yes, yes.
the Son of God, had nowhere,
nowhere.
To lay his head.
Hallelujah.
Tell me he was born in a stable.
Yeah.
He was born.
You know, we make room for the babies today, but we couldn't make room for Jesus. According to John 17:5, Jesus had glory with God before the world was. His incarnation was really an enfleshment. God manifest the flesh and justified in the spirit. Seen of the angels. Preached unto the Gentiles. Bleed on the world. Received up in glory.
Yes.
I'm talking about Jesus.
Jesus.
In addition to manufacturing, Christmas means a manger.
Mm-hmm.
Shepherds, angels,
yes.
music.
Yes.
But my Christian brothers and sisters, what Christmas really means is a master Christ.
Yes.
The Christ whom the disciples call master.
Yes.
Is he who is eternally restored on the bosom of the Father. Without a mother, and in time restored on the bosom of a mother.
Yes.
And it was done without a father.
Yes.
Son of man and son of God.
Mm.
He was in a manger.
Yes.
Later, he mastered a disease in the health.
Yes.
He brought blindness in the sight.
Yes,
yes, deafness in the hearing.
Yes.
Yes, he took layman's into the strength of muscles,
yes.
storms into calm,
yes.
death into life,
yes.
and grace into the resurrection glory.
Yes.
He mastered sin.
Yes.
He even mastered Satan.
Yes.
He mastered suffering
yes.
and he mastered death.
Yes, yes.
He mastered grace.
Yes.
And he mastered hell.
Yes.
All because he was the son
yes.
of a living God.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Well, Lord, I'm about ready to close now.
Wow.
But on Christmas morning,
yes.
every heart ought to say, thanks be unto God for his unspeakable gift.
Oh, yeah.
You did not ask for that gift.
Yeah.
It was freely bestowed on our Christian.
Yeah.
So on Christmas morning, when you receive your presents from your earthly friends, when you reject the gift of a gift from God, on Christmas morning, we may not bring a costly present at the manger brought, but we can give him pearls of our tears, the kiss of our love, as we move someone into the faith in him and give testimony that Jesus is our Savior, that he is our Lord. He is the Son of Man. He's without sin. Son of God with power and glory. Ain't he all right? Yes, the answer to the question, Christmas, what does it mean? Well, as I close, it means Master Lord. It means Jesus Christ. The one who is defined in John 3:16.
Yes.
So for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting day. Life, church, that's the true meaning of Christian. We gotta tell somebody, for God I live and for God I die. Y'all know when the president flies in, he comes in on Air Force One, and they got the nerve to put out red carpet when he walks down the stairs. But our Jesus came out the barn, nowhere to lay his head, but he stayed right there. Ain't he all right? I'm so glad that I know what the gift really means. It really means the word of God. Oh, Lord. I remember one day I was looking under the tree. There was no gifts for me and my brothers and sisters. But grandmama came out of the room. She said, Jesus, oh, Jesus is the reason for the season. The next few minutes, somebody came to the door. They dropped off a gift for each and every one of us. But before we got the gifts, we gave God the praises. Ain't it all right? Sparing our lives. Ain't it all right? I looked around. There was bread on the table. There's a roof over our head. And it was not leaking. We were sleeping in bunk beds, but we had somewhere to lay our heads. It was cold. We didn't have a real heater, but we had the stove. And grandmama made us some blankets. We were warm all through the night. Ain't it all right? And on Christmas Day, when we went outside, all the kids was playing and merry, but I thought about what grandmama said. You got your life, your health and strength, your clothes, and your right mind. Ain't it all right? The greatest gift is the word of God. Ain't it all right? Made up my mind. If I don't get anything else, I'm going to keep on saying thank you. For the Lord's been good. He's been good to me. He's been better to me than I've been to myself. So I say, Lord, create in me a clean heart. Renew in me the right spirit that I can tell somebody, for God I live. And for God I'll die. And one of these days is all going to be over with. But until that day comes my way, I pray that God will hold me in his bosom, rock me, rock. and all night. Then when you get ready to take me home to glory, let me leave with a smile on my face. Let me leave with love in my heart. Let me leave that I finished my course. I ran my race. Oh, Lord. Ain't he all right? He's all right with me. Thank you, Lord. Ain't he all right? He's all right. You're in your right mind. You've been blessed. You got a few material things. But keep on hanging on there. One of these days, you're going to get your real reward. And that's a trip from earth to glory. The spaceship can go higher. He made it to heaven. But the God I serve, he can take you from earth and take you to glory. Amen.